from the Marine Corps after 22 years of honorable and faithful service. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the invocation given by Sergeant Wheeler.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we are grateful to gather on this afternoon to honor the career of Master Sergeant Morel Moore. From the high seas of the great oceans to the mountains of Kosovo to duty stations around the globe, he has faithfully served thee and our nation for 22 years. We are thankful for the presence of Morel's family who traveled in from New Orleans. As we celebrate Morel's accomplishments today, may we be inspired to serve thee and our nation with greater purpose. Finally, I ask a blessing on Morel's family as they transition to a new life. Bless his family. May they have many joyful years together. Lord, hear our prayers. Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated. Now taking his position in the reviewing area is the retiring officer for today's ceremony, Lieutenant Matthew Norfleet.
Marines to be retired. Center. Park.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of our national anthem and remain standing for the presentation of the certificate of retirement. Reserve after 22 years of honorable and faithful active service. Robert B. Neller, Commandant of the Marine Corps. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Certificate of Appreciation for service in the Armed Forces of the United States of America, Master Sergeant Morel A. Moore, USMC. I extend to you my personal thanks and sincere appreciation for our grateful nation for your contribution of honorable service to our country. You have helped maintain the security of the nation during a critical time in its history with a devotion to duty and a spirit of sacrifice in keeping with the proud traditions of the military service. I trust that in coming years you will maintain an active interest in the armed forces and the purpose for which you have served. For those who follow in your footsteps will draw inspiration from your commitment, dedication, and sacrifices made to ensure the protection of our American freedoms. My best wishes for you, your happiness, and success in the future, President Donald Trump, Commander-in-Chief. Master Sergeant Moore, the Marine Corps has been your occupation and family for many years past. I am certain the memories, interests, and the future of our Corps will remain with you forever. Many desire to obtain your accomplished goals, but few compare to you. You have clearly demonstrated the exceptional leadership qualities and professional contributions we seek of our senior Marines. We are proud, as you must be, of your successful career. As a teacher to young Marines, a source of wise counsel, and as an example of those soldierly virtues we so admire, you have made a mark on the Corps that will remain long after you have left our active ranks. There are many young Marines you have influenced who will carry on in the same fine tradition that has always characterized the United States Marine Corps. You have my best wishes for good health and continued success in the years ahead. Semper Fidelis, Robert B. Neller, General, U.S. Marine Corps, Commandant of the Marine Corps. Dear Master Sergeant Moore, on the occasion of your retirement, I would like to extend my congratulations and heartfelt thanks for your many years of dedicated service and selfless devotion to our country and Corps. You have made tremendous contributions and sacrifices throughout your Marine Corps career. As you prepare to enter this new chapter of your life, you can look back with immense pride and satisfaction on all you have accomplished. You have set an example of professionalism and leave a standard of excellence for all Marines who carry on the legacy of our Corps. My wife, Andrea, joins me in wishing you continued success in the future. Semper Fidelis, Ronald L. Green, 18th Sergeant Major of the Marine Corps. Now being escorted is Master Sergeant Moore's wife, Alfreya. Certificate of Appreciation presented to Alfreya Moore on the occasion of the retirement of your husband from active duty. You have earned the Corps' grateful appreciation for your unselfish, faithful, and devoted service. Your unfailing support and understanding helped to make possible your husband's lasting contribution to our great nation. Given under my hand this 18th day of March 2018, David W. Maxwell, Brigadier General, United States Marine Corps, Commanding General, 2nd Marine Logistics Group. Ladies and gentlemen, the retiring officer for today's ceremony, Lieutenant Matthew Norfleet.
All right, thank you all for coming out and seeing a special day for Master Sergeant Moore. It's been 22 years from stepping on those yellow footprints to come to this day. Now, the true thanks goes to his family. Miss Alfreya, thank you so much for being faithful to your husband and standing by him through 3 15th MEU deployments. I know that was not a fun experience since I just left one myself and my wife couldn't wait to see me. So after 3, I can't imagine how excited you were to have your husband finally home. We certainly wish you, on the behalf of 2nd MLG, a wonderful future and farewell. From the halls of Montezuma, Master Sergeant Moore.
I'm not a comedian right now, but I'm not a comedian. It's been a long time coming. I can't say it enough. Going from every PFC to every warrant officer to every lieutenant, it's a long journey. Long journey. Wow. Never thought this day would happen. I remember being in high school and everybody was going through, oh, you're the most successful person, you're gonna be this, you're gonna be that. And I remember being in high school and I had the Army ROTC uniform on. Everybody was like laughing at me, oh, that pickle suit, you know, so forth, so on. And on behold, look at me right now. Look at how many of my high school peers, quote unquote, suck.com. But in high school, they think the dudes be the cool person. Oh man, you're going to be the next NBA player, football player, and so forth. Come on, no one says military. If your three-year-old kid, son or daughter, came to you right now and said, "Mom, Dad, I'm joining the military," you're like, "Get out of here," so forth, so on. It's not a traditional path. But I'm a huge fan of when a person graduates from high school, they have four options. The first option is go to college. Second option is to get a job. The third option is to join the military. The fourth option is to do absolutely nothing. There's no other options in the world. So I picked one of the four options, and I've become very successful at that. But it's not just me. It's this tribe of people over here, to include my wife. If y'all, well, of course you don't know my secrets and everything, but last night trying to get clothes for the kids and so forth, so on, at the last second, and she made it happen. So I thank you for that. It's very appreciative. My family, my mother, and they're not here, they're in New Orleans, and I appreciate them for all they've taught me throughout the years. It's been a real struggle. I can't say it enough. I remember being a PFC walking on the grass, and First Sergeant Joe Bob like, "Get off the grass." Like, "What the hell? I can't walk on the grass. I just PT'd on it like 5 minutes ago." But I can't walk on the grass. The core has definitely changed. Boot camp was definitely an experience. Everybody's up on the yellow footprints and did the thing so forth. But I think a lot of people got detached of what they joined the Marine Corps for. Here's what I mean by this. Everybody saw recruiter man X or recruiter woman and said, "I want to be a better person." And for some ungodly reason, from the yellow footprints until now, a lot of things have changed. What changed? "I want to be a college graduate, but to find yourself in the barracks playing the Xbox all day long. I want to be this great person. I want to be a great leader. I want to do all these great things, but you find yourself with the bad peer group. And then you blame it on the sergeant, the corporal, the lieutenant, the warrant officer, the chief warrant officer, whatever the rank might be. It's your fault." I will say this. I don't have many friends in the Marine Corps. I have a lot of associates, but as far as friends, I have very few. And for the reason of, I just want to be successful. This is the independent sport, just in case y'all did not know this. But some of y'all have these cliques that's so tight. "I don't want to go against the grain. I want to be next to Johnny and Susan." But guess what happens to Johnny and Susan over a period of time? They PCS. Oh, they EAS. And then who's left back? You are. But damn, I was supposed to be with this crew doing these great things. No. But you step on your footprint and everything that you wanted to happen went away. Just think about that for a second. What happened between how did your transformation of the Marine Corps go? Did it go the way you wanted it to, or did it not? And if it did not, what along the way did you not do? I can't say it enough. I appreciate everybody for being here. Let's go around the room right fast. Larry Johnson. This is my roommate as a Lance Corporal forever ago. That was in, 1997? What were you doing in 1997? Wasn't even thought of. You didn't thought of. Well, you thought of, but it wasn't in the manner you thought it should have been. So for someone, you thought of though. It was all over the place. But you thought of though. You thought of. I appreciate you being my roommate. I appreciate filling the field day 3 or 4 times. I appreciate it, my man. Appreciate that. I can't tell you enough. This guy had the most smelliest underwear of all time. From time to time, there was a little streak going through, but you know what? And the bad thing is, too, there was a washer and dryer in the barracks, but he wanted to do the clothes clippings in the room with a little string line, but hey, I appreciate it, brother. I'm going to slide around here right fast. Maria Gonzalez. We go back couple years, like at Camp Pendleton and so forth, so on. She is an awesome individual, but depending on who you talk to, a little rough around the edges. But for some reason, we clicked off very well. You're a great person. I'm glad you took the trip from Paris out to come here and come see me on retire. I will definitely be at your retirement. You're an awesome person. Chief Orange Sheets, my boy, Blue. This is the greatest Pittsburgh fan of all time, even though they suck.com, but hey, it is what it is, though. It is what it is. Cleveland's going to make the playoffs this year. Just want to mention it to you right fast. I wish we would have hung out more due to the rank restrictions and so forth. Swan, you and me were on the same level. Same level. So definitely appreciate your time. I'm gonna mention Master Guns. He didn't want me to. He's a great guy. This guy's a comedian. Believe it or not, he got a lot of jokes. He's got to get through a whole bunch of stuff to get to it, though. I don't know how to say it anywhere other than that, though. From day one, we hit off. We hit a home run. Oh, maybe it was a single. Maybe it was a bunt. I don't know. Whatever it was, so far.
It was a foul ball.
Hey, but you know, with a foul ball, you get more and more strikes, but more and more tips at it, so far, so on. So I definitely appreciate the leadership. I definitely appreciate the brotherhood, so forth, so on. Hey, you're my brother from another mother. Even Joe, I'm gonna leave it alone. Definitely appreciate it. What my man that Curtis said, what was Curtis Williams, where did he go? He had to bounce.
He left me.
It is what it is, so forth, so on. Maston Sanchez, if y'all don't know, there's a picture in the office from 1999 with a bunch of Marines in it. He's in the picture too, but you really can't see him. You know, every now and then you got a little couple of marks in the picture, so forth, so on. His face just so happened to be marked. Maybe he did it himself because he had hair at the time. I don't know exactly what happened, but I definitely appreciate you, brother. Gunny Casales, Gunny Gonzalez, I definitely appreciated everything that happened on the travel deck. It was a hectic deck, but guess what we did? A 95 and a 97 on my cat score, so hey, awesome. Kudos, so forth, so on. Now it's the middle portion of the show. Yet again, I want to thank my wife and my kids. Make sure I don't forget about you guys. Man, it's been a long road. Crying, it's not gonna happen. Trust me. Don't worry about it. We're good, so forth, so on. First song, Stevens, my man, Paris Allen. That's my guy right there. He is the New England Patriots fan that just didn't win Super Bowl. But oh well, you know. Maybe next year, maybe the year after that, maybe the year after that. I don't know. I can't call it. Caps Lock Ohio, sir. Travel debt. We made things happen. It wasn't the best way, depending on who you talk to, but at the end of the day, at 95 and 97, it all happens. Definitely appreciate it. Chief Antiragnos, we go way back with the staff sergeant. Way back, he actually had hair, but that's not the story though, not the story. Maybe he didn't, but oh, I don't remember it. I really can't call it. Juan Severo, sir, definitely appreciate yourself. Well, I definitely appreciate you. I wish we had more time to hang out, so forth, so on, but due to the break restrictions and so forth, so on, you're my guy. Definitely appreciate you. Maston Wallace, my man. This guy right here on the, what is it, the 15th Mule? 26th Mule. I've been on a lot of Mules. Like, excuse me right fast. He used to be a baller. The key word is used to. Now, he can't make a free throw. But hey, another story though. What was that, 99? 90, yeah, not long time ago. One thing about the Marine Corps is, if you're a PFC, Lance Corporal Sergeant, I was a corporal at the time, I believe he was a sergeant. Corporal. Whatever the rank may be, you're going to see these people again. So always stay in good faith, good terms with these people, because you just never know. I'll give you a story right fast. I'm Corporal Moore, doing my thing, so forth, so on, and Staff Sergeant on the deck, Staff Sergeant Pedraza. Years pass by, I do my thing, so forth, so on. Now I'm Gunny Moore, she's still Staff Sergeant Pedraza. She said, hey, Gunny, can I go to the PX? I'm like, goodness, how is that to be turned around? I was a corporal when she was a staff sergeant. Now I'm a gunny, and she's still a staff sergeant. Amazing, ain't it? Hey, be appreciative. If you're the senior level people, you just never know who's going to catch up to you. You never know. My man in the back, Maston Tompkins. Love you, brother. Well, retired Chris, but you know, it is what it is. Love you, my man. If you guys don't know, I'm going to this great invention called Tennessee. It's a great place. If you don't know, come visit me. I might answer the door. I might not, depending on who you are. Mexicans, please, I'm not going to do it. Don't.
Don't knock on the door.
But like, praise yourself, fool.
What? Huh? Really? That's what we're doing right now? Sending off, please, sir. Thank you for the kind words. I definitely appreciate you. We have multiple conversations. I can't say enough about you. You have a great, promising career. To my wife, to my backbone, to my rib cage, to my ankle, fingernail. Can't say enough about you. Not gonna sit here and cry, but I won't. It's not gonna happen. I'm trying to do this without saying a joke, which is my normal forte, but you're beautiful, you're intelligent, you definitely hold down the household when I'm out there running, taking care of Joe Blow's DUI at 2 o'clock in the morning. Why are you getting these phone calls at 2 o'clock in the morning? Because somebody got in trouble. Why didn't I talk to you? Well, the protocol is so forth, so on. It's a lot for all of these spouses out here. I don't really think that for a non-married Marine to understand what a spouse goes through. They are just as important to the Marine Corps as we are. To my mother-in-law, thank you for showing up. I definitely appreciate it. To my kids, I did all of this to make sure that each and every one of you are successful. That's the best way I can say it. I just want to make sure that each and every one of you are successful. You'll never see me on a street corner holding up a sign saying military, looking for food or for money and so forth, because I have done so much. I've ran so much. My body hurts. My mouth hurts right now, but I can't say it enough that it's easy to be a parent. Anybody can be a parent. That's easy. You can make a baby. Well, it's a little harder than that. A little game involved and a little bit of smoozing. But you know, it is what it is. But almost anybody can make a baby. But can you take care of a baby? That's what I really want everybody to understand. You can call me a lot of things. You a butthole, you smell.com. Okay, I didn't take a shower that day. But you can never call me a bad father. And if you can you back it up? So I definitely appreciate you all, and she's sleeping, but hey, thank you. Really appreciate it. My time has came and has went. I see nothing but the future of the Marine Corps going to bigger and better things. Yes, I will not be wearing this uniform anymore, but I'm always gonna be a Marine. I guarantee if I see one of you all in or out of uniform, I'm gonna buy you the first round. Probably. Now the second and third, you're gonna have to buy me, but let's be honest. Things I'm gonna miss in the Marine Corps. I'm gonna miss the Chow Hall. The Chow Hall is the most awesome thing ever. $3.45 for a meal? Y'all don't understand how cheap that is to get a buffet for $3.45. Every morning I possibly can, I get breakfast from the Chow Hall. Things I should have done in the Marine Corps. I should have got a college degree. For everybody sitting in this audience right now who have all this time on your hands, I highly recommend getting a college degree. Yes, I got lucky. Let me give you a small backstory on it. I'm hired on to be HR starting on June the 4th of this year for $50,000 a year. Great, it sounds good and so forth, so on. I got lucky. What about you? You know what? As a recruiter, I joined the Marine Corps to go to college. Like I keep on saying, that you find yourself in the barracks playing the PlayStation. For some of y'all, this is a 4-year plan. For some of y'all, it's an 8-year plan because your 4-year plan didn't work out. You have to reenlist and you're begging Master Guns. Master Guns, please give me a letter of recommendation so I can reenlist. What are you doing today? Why wait till tomorrow? Get your butt. Simon's college classes. Get the college degree. I wish I'd have been a 300 PFT here, but I wasn't. You know, it is what it is. But I'm a 297, but I want to leave out of here with one last thing. I remember being a corporal. What made my corporal and sergeant days so awesome was calling cadence. How many corporals and sergeants right now can't call cadence? Don't raise your hands, because I know there's a lot of y'all out there. I like to do one small cadence, a James Brown cadence. If you don't know it, I'm gonna help y'all a little bit. Can I get a little crowd participation? Everybody can help me out a little bit? Round of applause or something? There we go. Thank God, the microphone's working. So I'm gonna say a quick piece, and if you guys can fill in the lines, and then I'm gonna call it a day. Are we good? All right, cool, here we go.
I feel good.
I know that I
would not. I feel good. I know that I would not. So good. So good. I got you. I feel nice. With sugar and spice. I feel nice. With sugar and spice. So nice. So nice. I got you. Keep the party going.
Ladies and gentlemen, flowers are now being presented to Miss Alfredo Moore. And candy to wake the kids up. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the playing of Anchors Away and the Marines hymn. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. This concludes today's ceremony, and on behalf of Master Sergeant Moore and his family, thank you for attending. We ask that you please remain seated for the passing of Old Glory. United States of America. My name is Old Glory. I fly atop the world's tallest buildings. I stand watch in America's halls of justice. I fly majestically over institutions of learning. I stand guard with the greatest military power in the world. Look up and see me. I stand for peace, honor, truth, and justice. I stand for freedom. I am confident, I am arrogant, I am proud. When I am flown with my fellow banners, my head a little higher, my colors a little truer, I bow to no one. I am recognized all over the world. I am worshipped, I am saluted, I am respected, I am revered, I am loved, and I am feared. I have fought in every battle of every war for more than 200 years. Gettysburg, Shiloh, Appomattox, San Juan Hill, the trenches of France, the Argonne Forest, Rome, the beaches of Normandy, Guam, Okinawa, Korea, Vietnam, in the Persian Gulf, and a score of places long forgotten by all but those who are with me. I was there. I led my Marines. I followed them. I watched over them. They loved me. I was on a small hill in Iwo Jima. I was dirty, battle-worn, and tired, but my Marines and sailors cheered me. I was proud. I've been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on streets of countries that I've helped free. It does not hurt, for I am invincible. I have been soiled, burned, torn, and trampled on the streets of my own country. And when it is with those who I have served in battle, it hurts, but I shall overcome, for I am strong. I have slipped the bonds of earth and from my vantage point on the moon. I stand watch over uncharted frontiers of space. I have been a silent witness to all of America's finest hours. But in my finest hour comes when I am torn into strips to be used as bandages for my wounded comrades on the field of battle. When I fly half-mast to honor my Marines and sailors. When I lie in the trembling arms of a grieving mother at the graveside of her fallen son or daughter. I am proud. My name is Old Glory. Long may I wave. Dear God, long may I wave. For 22 years, this Marine has stood the watch. While many of us lay about in our bunks at night, this Marine stood the watch. While others of us were attending schools, this Marine stood the watch. And yes, even before many of us were born, this Marine stood the watch. As our families watched the storm clouds of war brewing on the horizons of history, he stood the watch. This Marine looked ashore and saw his family often needing guidance, but he knew he must stay because he had the watch. For years, he stood the watch that our fellow countrymen could sleep soundly, in safety, knowing that this Marine would stand the watch. Today, we are here to say that the watch stands relieved. Relieved by those of you that you have led, guided, and trained. Master Sergeant Moore, you stand relieved. We have the watch. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending. Those invited guests for the 1800 party to be partied on. We'll be meeting at the officers club. Thank you. Have a great evening.
Yeah, we're going to see.